It is no secret that we at Reviews vs. the World love us some Batman! But as much as the other guys love Batman, their Batman love isn't nearly what I've got. In fact, I would say that probably out of absolutely everything Batman related, I would be the expert to go to. I have such a deep love for not only Batman, but all of the Justice League and every DC property. In fact, I wouldn't hesitate to say that I am the biggest Batman fan that I know. So of course, it is I who gets to give you your most wonderful first full Batman-related review. It's Reviews vs. Batman Arkham Knight on the PlayStation 4.
Shocked, Dark Knight? Stunned? You didn't expect this, did you? That is because you are no match for me, Edward Nigma, the Riddler, and your intellectual superior.
Batman Arkham Knight is the newest in a series that shows that games can do superheroes justice. It is a game with a simple premise. Be the Batman. As luck would have it,
I'm Batman.
Arkham Knight takes place after the city of Gotham has been evacuated due to a threat from Scarecrow to use his fear toxin on the entire population. Seems familiar somehow.
There you are. There's nothing to fear, but fear itself.
That's it. Although the premise itself is not wholly unique in the world of Batman, there's one new element that is brand new to the Batverse. The Arkham Knight. A mysterious mass figure with an army at his command and a serious grudge against Batman. Luckily, Batman gets a new element to the franchise to help in his fight for Gotham. Behold, the Batmobile! You also have quite the rogues gallery here, from Scarecrow and the Arkham Knight, to Penguin, Two-Face, Firefly, and Professor Pig. That's right. Professor Freaking Pig. You also have allies who can be played in short bursts for added fun, including Catwoman, Nightwing, Robin, and Azrael. Oh, and it's Halloween because it has to be Halloween or Christmas to be taken seriously or whatever. Holidays. Batman, work together. This game is fun. The combat is every bit as good as you remember, as you will easily punch, counter, throw batarangs, and drive henchmen's skulls into light fixtures because, well, you can. The system feels nuanced and simple, but throws curves at you that will cause you to reevaluate your tactics and try again. The Predator sections, filled with stealth, gadgets, and mayhem, are also back and as strong as ever. If you're like me, these are what keep you coming back over and over to the game. But of course, that's not all that's great here. The story is phenomenal. For those keeping track, events occurred at the end of Arkham City that had the potential to mess Batman's psyche to shreds. And the story completely delivers in this regard. Although Batman makes dumb decisions over and over, you can't help but feel bad for him. The twists for Bruce are dark and not what I expected from the game.
She said she got out. She left hours ago.
Stay calm. We'll get her back.
Which one? Who's got my little girl?
Fear makes you predictable. I am in complete control.
The glorious voice acting certainly does help as well. Don Noble as Scarecrow and Jonathan Banks as Gordon add some major gravitas to the events. And Kevin Conroy continues to impress as Batman. This game also brings back my favorite element of Arkham Origins. Detective work. You find yourself recreating crime scenes, examining dead bodies, and actually, I don't know, being a detective? Yeah, it pays off really well, and provides some great moments. Oh, and this game is pretty. I'll just let you watch for a second. Wow.
End of the line, Dent.
Never count me out of the game.
All right, you've probably already heard that the Batmobile is pretty divisive. And I definitely fall on the negative end of the spectrum. The Batmobile has two modes, Battle and Pursuit. Well, I thought that Battle mode was actually sort of fun at first. Pursuit should die in a fire. Yeah, just like that. You see, one of my favorite things about Arkham City and Arkham Origins was flying through the air, finding that balance of dive, speed, and grapnel boosts to be calming and a great way to just get around and enjoy the game. But this game loves to force you into the Batmobile as often as possible. Especially for boss fights. Boss fights were wonderful in the other games. Here, the majority of them end up being in the Batmobile, playing stealth, driving around. Oh, and don't even get me started on the Riddler. Oh, so Riddler, you are a villain who loves wordplay and riddles, leaving clues as a challenge for our hero? Well, why don't you create underground racetracks where Brady will die over and over and over and over again. Ugh. Now, it's possible that I just suck, but the Batmobile doesn't seem to have nearly the thought or simplicity that Rocksteady has found with the rest of the gameplay, and that is seriously a problem. Now, a minute ago, I did praise Arkham Knight's story, and overall, it is outstanding and does some great things and goes to some wonderful dark places. But some of the twists will make you upset. Now, I won't give anything away to you, but let me just say that Arkham Knight's identity was a letdown. And more than that, the game seems content to backpedal on some of these big story elements, and it becomes a little bit disappointing. It just loses some of its flavor. And then you have some villains that seem woefully underutilized. Two-Face and Penguin were such a huge part of Arkham City, and here they are just thrown to the background with little one-off side missions that don't really matter. When all is said and done, this is still a mighty fine game, and easily my favorite on the PlayStation 4 so far. Now, that is very high praise if you know me, because I love my PlayStation 4, and this game just gives me a reason to keep on going back and turning back on. The exploration, story, and combat are all top-notch, even if the Batmobile can let you down a little bit. That's why I give Batman Arkham Knight 3 Robins out of 4.
Despite all of my little quibbles that I have with the game, it is an amazing experience. And I would highly recommend that you go out right now and buy this any way that you can, on any platform that you can. I mean, you can do PlayStation 4 like me, or you can do Xbox One, or even PC. Wait. Ugh. Sorry about that.
We're reviews! Bye!